Everyone, this is Sharon Michaels of SharonMichaelsAuthor.com, and I want to say good morning, and I want to talk to you about something that I woke up in the middle of the night thinking I wanted to discuss with you, and that's goal setting, because this is the end of one month and the beginning of another month, and sometimes we forget to set our goals the beginning of the month. I also want to talk to you about hope. Let's not ever give up hope. Hope for the future. And that's, to me, what goal setting does. It gives us hope. I want to talk about myself just a little bit. So this Facebook Live may be a little longer than normal. And I like talking about myself. What can I say? I keep reading romance novels, cozy mysteries, novels altogether. And they keep talking about older people, elderly people, the old person that lives down the street. The elderly people with the arthritis and their, anyway. And then when I see how old they are, I think, wait a minute, that's my age. They're calling me old. They're calling me elderly. I can't believe it. And you know why? Because I don't feel that way. And this is what I want to say to you. My husband and I are still making goals. We're making goals for 2022 and 2023, and we're making vision boards, and we're planning for the future. And most of you know, we're going to be in our mid-70s, and that's not old. I never want to give up hope for the future. I don't want to believe that the future is so bleak that I can't write a goal, that I can't believe I can achieve that goal. As long as I've got my health, as long as I've got my mind, as long as I've got my motivation, as long as I have people in my life who love me and I love them, I'm going to keep going forward in positive ways. No matter what's going on around us, I'm going to keep going forward because I believe in hope. I believe in going forward. I believe that we can achieve our goals. So when I read these books and they talk about these doctors who should retire and these people who are old and they're, you know, 70, and that's younger than I am. And I'm thinking, no, that's not how I want my life to be. I want to keep going forward. And that's what I want you to think about too. I don't care if you're 20, if you're 70, if you're 80, if you're 90, still write those goals. Still keep going forward. Still believe in the world. Still believe that you can make a difference, that you can make a difference in the world with your positive energy, with what you believe you can achieve. Okay, with that said, I want you to think about writing your goals for the next month, because that's this weekend already, is August. So I'm going to take some excerpts from my book, 21 I love the light, right? 21 Days to Living Your Dreams, which is a step-by-step goal-setting book that I wrote a few years back, and it comes in Kindle Unlimited, and in paperback. But I just want to give you some really quick tips that you can do this weekend to focus on your goals and going forward in August. No more excuses, no more negativity, let's just do this. All right. I want you to choose, and my goal setting is very, very basic. I don't have apps. I don't use my computer. I use pen and paper. So I'm old-fashioned. Oh, did I say that word? I am, I'm just going to use pen and paper. I'm not using that word. All right, I'm going to write my number one goal for August. What is the number one thing that I want to achieve in August? And then what I'm going to do is break it down into 4 weeks, because there's really 4 work weeks in August. And then each week I'm going to write down 3 activities that will take me to achieving that week's goal, which will take me to achieving August's goal. So what I'm trying to get across is write your awesome August goal. I mean, be realistic about what's going on. I mean, if you want to take a vacation somewhere and the state is closed, I guess you can't do that. But write a realistic but yet awesome goal for August. Break it down into 4 weeks, and then break each week into a bite-sized piece. The key is not being overwhelmed. The key is consistency. The key is being knowing that you're going forward, working towards something that means something to you, that has importance to you, all right? So you're going to write your awesome, realistic, but still awesome August goal. You're going to break it down into 4 weeks. You're going to break each week into the most important three things that will take you to your goal. And every day, you are going to write down at least one activity that will achieve that week's goal, all right? So you're working on it every day, every week, to achieve this month's goal, which is probably going to take you to your yearly goal, right? But another important thing that I do every month is, why is achieving the goal important to me? Why is achieving August goals important to me? Why? And I'm talking about the emotional aspect. You know, when I work with coaching clients, a lot of them say to get out of debt. That's wonderful. That's a great goal. But how will it feel when you're out of debt? What will that do for your lifestyle? What will keep you motivated when there's ups and downs and disappointments? So I want you to hone in on why achieving this goal is important to you. More than just, I want to get out of debt, or I want to go on vacation, which is important. I'm not saying it's not. But how are you going to feel when you're on vacation? What are you going to do when you're on vacation? Where are you going to go? That type of thing. I want you to emotionally accept this goal. I hope I'm making myself clear. But I really believe in this. I really believe it's important. I really believe that we need to have hope to go forward. And I know you can achieve your goal. Just break it down into bite-sized pieces. Stay consistent. Stay motivated. Get that momentum going. And just know that you can do it. You can do it. Bite-sized pieces. Have that why right in your heart. That why has to be important to you, because it's probably going to take you to even a bigger goal. But these, you know, accomplishments, give yourself a pat on the back every time you accomplish the goal for the day, the priority for the day, the goal for the week, the goal for the month. Don't just say, well, it's done. Give yourself a pat on the back. Say an atta girl. I did it. I knew I could do it. Yay. That type of thing. But, you know, have fun with it too. I guess I just want to say, if you really want more details on how to achieve your goals, 21 Days to Living Your Goals, available on Amazon in paperback and also in Kindle and Kindle Unlimited. I woke up in the middle of the night thinking that I wanted to do this Facebook Live and talk to you about this, because it's really important. And working with some of my coaching clients, I'm feeling the negativity kind of taking over us. I don't want you to lose the hope. I don't want you to lose the motivation. Know that together we're going to get through this, one step at a time. So what is the one thing you want to accomplish before you go to bed every night? One positive thing that you want to accomplish. Be grateful. Be thankful. Know that together we're getting there. So again, this is Sharon Michaels of SharonMichaelsAuthor.com. And you can see I have nonfiction books available, empowering nonfiction books available on Amazon. And also, I've started writing fiction, because that's just something, that's a goal of mine. That's something I've always wanted to do. And I thought, oh, why not? Why not? I'm having fun and they're selling. So it's a good goal, right? Again, Sharon Michaels, SharonMichaelsAuthor.com. You'll find my books up on Amazon. This is something that spoke to my heart in the middle of the night, and I wanted to share it with you. So set your goal. Know that you take it in bite-sized pieces. I believe in you. Stay safe. Stay healthy. Stay motivated. Stay productive. Know we are in this together, and together we're going to get there very positively. So thank you so much for watching this video, and thank you so much for being part of my readers group, or my Facebook pages, or my Instagram pages, or my Pinterest pages, and buying my books and subscribing to my newsletter. Know how much I appreciate you. And anything I can do to support you in achieving your goal, please leave comments. If you have a question, I'm here for you. So again, Sharon Michaels, thank you so much for being a part of my life. I appreciate you.